What is happening, guys? Mike here. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to take a look at a new brand for the channel and a new genre of products. I mean, this is all around exciting. We got new brands, new products. We're talking about fragrances today and a brand called Scentbird, which I'm sure you've heard of. I'm sure you've already heard of this brand. I mean, they are widely popular. They're everywhere these days. And why am I just now talking about them? Well, for one, I've hesitated with fragrance brands because I've got a scent allergy. This is also widely known. I mean, I mention it in like 90% of my reviews, but for those that maybe are new to the channel, by the way, I'd love for you to subscribe. That would be awesome. Welcome. I'd really appreciate that. Yes, I do have a scent allergy. What happens for me when that occurs is it's usually when I'm around floral stuff, by the way, floral stuff especially, but it's not limited to that. It's mostly floral stuff though, but what happens is my airway kind of closes up and I just can't breathe too well. So needless to say, these types of brands and fragrances in general have been tough on me to do in the past. But to keep things short and focused on what we're talking about today, what got me here started first with making my own products. And with doing that, I did a lot of scent exploration there to kind of just isolate what triggers those reactions within me and what maybe doesn't. And that allowed me to get a lot more insight into what my limitations were and what types of things I could be around, you know. And I used that here with this brand and choosing the fragrances to go with. Well, I did that with one of them. I mean, I did that with one of the fragrances that we're going to talk about today. The other two I kind of went on a limb about, but we're going to talk about that here in a second. But before all that, before we get to all that, what is Scentbird? For those that might not have heard them, for those that might be living under a rock, like I said, they're pretty much everywhere these days. I've seen a bunch of stuff on them, but Scentbird is a fragrance subscription service that allows you to broaden your scented horizons, if you will, by trying out different scents without buying a full bottle, which is really cool to me because fragrances, you know, when I started looking into some of these, they're very expensive. They are extremely expensive, well out of my price range. But with this service, you see, you pay $14.95 per month and you choose the scent you want to try. You get full access to their catalog of fragrances. And for that, you get one of these here, this 8-milliliter bottle that holds about 140 sprays, they say. And the idea is that this will last you until you're ready to order your next fragrance the following month. You know, they say it lasts a month. I think it actually lasts a little bit longer than a month. That's just me, but that's what they say. You know, they say it lasts about a month. I think it lasts a little longer. But a second ago, I mentioned the fragrances I chose, so I want to go over that now. Knowing I have a scent allergy, I tried to go about this in a smart way. They allowed me to choose three fragrances to check out in this video, and for the first one, I went off of one that I was already familiar with, but never actually had in my possession to try, and that was Creed Aventus. This is another very popular scent. It's all over the place. I really wanted to try out the original, and let me tell you, I was not disappointed. I can absolutely see why people love this cologne, this fragrance, this scent, whatever you want to call it. I mean, it is fantastic. I can see why it's so popular and why it's copied so much. Honestly, it's really cool that they offer this too, you know, in the program, because a full bottle of this stuff is crazy expensive. It's just unbelievable. So I thought it was really cool that I could get it in this and try it out, because like I said, I've had, like, you know, copies of it and all the hair products that have done Aventus since, I've had that, but it really doesn't do it justice. You have to try the original. I mean, trying the original blows all those out of the water, in my opinion. It's awesome. I really love this one. But for the other two, though, the other two, I kind of went in those blind, you know, because Creed Aventus and some of the other ones by Creed and, you know, some other ones like Salvage, you know, those are the only colognes besides, you know, Tom Ford and things like that are the ones that I had heard of, you know, and they didn't have, you know, the other ones from Creed. They didn't have the other ones from Tom Ford. I'm told that some of those are coming soon, which is really cool. I'm probably going to have to look into those for the future. But the other two, I kind of went in blind a little bit. So what I did, this is honestly what I did. I grabbed a copy of GQ. I looked through that, and what I found was that there was two fragrances advertised in the magazine. I just picked those. I just grabbed them. That's honestly what I did. One of them, it looks pretty cool. I mean, the ad looked awesome. It's Eros from Versace. It's a little strong for me personally. It kind of, you know, threw me off pretty good. The other one is Dolce & Gabbana for men, and that one is for sure way too strong for me. I mean, I sprayed this thing and just instantly regretted it. Like, oh my God, I can't breathe. I cannot. That one, I just got to throw it out there. And I want to make sure and say that that's not the fragrance's fault. It doesn't mean that they smell bad or, you know, they suck as colognes. This is just how I'm wired. This is just me. So it's not that they are bad per se. They're just not able to work with my allergy. I'm just being straight up about it and being transparent. that's just how it worked out. I will say though, the Eros from Versace was a bit better for me, and looking closer, I can see that it has lemon in there, notes of lemon and green apple. And those are some of the notes that I've isolated that I can work with, but it also has geranium and vetiver and oak moss. Those are tough ones for me for sure, but it was a bit better. Going back though, to the Aventus, my God, this stuff is wonderful. I love this fragrance. I mean, I know they officially describe Aventus as kind of like a fruity fragrance, but I don't really see it that way. Granted, I'm not an authority by any means on fragrances. I got a screwed up nose, so maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. It's just not what I get when I smell it. It just doesn't come off to me as fruity. It's musky. It's smooth. It just receives well in my messed up nose. I don't really know how else to say it. I mean, it just smells amazing to me. Going back over to Scentbird though, there's not much else really to go through there. I mean, that's how their service works. You choose any fragrance from their list of brands, and they have a lot of top brands, and they're adding more all the time too. So it's not just cheap brands. You know, they seem to be real decent, good brands, you know, like Creed, for example. I'm not a fragrance expert again by any means, but $14.95 and you get to choose the authentic brand name fragrance. That does seem pretty good in my opinion. But I am also very curious to see what you guys, you fragrance guys, some of you that are into this more than me, what you guys think of this service. And I want to open up that dialogue in the comment section there to kind of get, you know, see what you guys think. I always enjoy seeing what you guys think. Personally, I think the offerings are pretty good, and I think it's a really good service at a good price. I think they have a lot of choices, and I think for me, this sample of Aventus again will probably last more than 30 days, probably looking at closer to 40 or something like that, closer to 40, maybe 42 days. I don't use it very heavy, you know, one or two spritzes and I'm good. So I can probably drag this out. But I do want to see what you guys think about this service and what your opinion is. Like I said, let me know in the comment section what you guys think. And while you're there, make sure you tap that like button for me. And if you have not yet subscribed, you definitely got to do that. Just help me out. Hit the button. Join us here on the channel. So thank you in advance for hitting that subscribe button. If you haven't already, it's a huge help to me. So thank you very much in advance for doing that. Thank you also for joining me here for this video. I will, of course, be right back here with you with an all new video very soon. And until then, take it easy. I'll see you next time.